What's up, everybody? It's Eric Johnson from Arete Throws Nation. I'm back. Here we go with another video on the inverted C. Thankfully, I don't hear that as much as I used to a few years ago, but I had a client today who was with their coach and they were teaching it and I explained why it wasn't good, and I'm about to do that in this video. Let's check it out. Hey everyone, it's Eric Johnson from Arete Throws Nation, and in this video, what we're gonna discuss is the inverted C, or the C back. This is the updated version. I did this video, one of my first YouTube videos, where I kinda wasn't used to the camera and I talked a lot softer, and I think the information was good, but we've also evolved our system quite a bit. I've evolved the system tremendously. So point is, the system has gotten much better. Videos, I think, are 10 times better. And one of the things we talked about was the inverted C. We still hold by the inverted C position. When you look at the best throwers in the world, they're all here. So what that means is we're gonna see them all coming forward and we're gonna see the stack. Now what you see is that stack, I mean knee, hip, shoulder, boom. I'm on this angle, right? So as I throw and as I get that hip in front and I'm releasing that discus out here, or I'm releasing that shot put, again, we have the head back. Some people teach throw the head back. Now I wanna make it clear, I've coached a handful of athletes that were taught that, and it is just a mind-numbing pain in the ass as a coach to have to fix that. Let's get a couple things straight. One, the head back position is a result of stretch reflex. It's very similar to what you see with an Olympic lifter when they drive those hips and they shrug and they're gonna be pulling up to catch, the head smashes back. That stretch reflex. That's not a conscious head throw. And in the throw, it's the same thing. So the inverted C is not a throw the chest up, throw the shoulders back. It is a keep everything here, push the knee and the hip into the throw so that I'm finishing in this position. And as I throw, I'm going to get that stretch reflex position in the head. So remember, what appears to be a C is the heel, the elevation of the hip, the pushing of the knee as it's rotating, rotating the delivery side past the block side, getting the head stretching as it's gonna pull, and the ideal position is a little bit of an angle down so that we're creating a longer radius, which increases time applied to the discus and speed and longer path, all that good stuff. And so what we see right at that point is that stretch reflex position, which gives the appearance of an inverted C or a C back. We want to make it clear, it's a position and a reaction to a dynamic position, not a chest up, head back. And I was coaching an athlete today who came in, coach politely, you know, I asked, are you teaching this? I was like, yeah, I wouldn't do that anymore. And I explained why. And here I'll give you the same explanation. A quarterback, most people watching this probably like football too. When you're a quarterback has to create a throwing motion. They come through the block arm, right? Even for a quarterback has to stop. They come through and they come through a block. Now, how many quarterbacks do you see in the NFL doing this? Those aren't quarterbacks you see in the NFL or in college football because they're not good enough to be at that level. That's why you'll never see that. Very much the same general mechanics. We have to come through the block, pushing that knee and hip as it rotates, creating this kind of position and creating a stretch reflex response as we stretch, and that gives the appearance of the C, but it is not to be confused with an actual C. So we maintain the stack, and most of the time, most throwers should be conscious of coming forward as they do, because that angle is changing, the angle's set and the angle's coming through. And if they're a non-reversing thrower, they're still coming through, and we'll pop up a few videos that explain what I'm talking about, but you'll see. So don't teach the inverted C. It's not correct. I stand by that. Had a few people send me some disagreements, but if you look at it mechanically, it is a mechanical position, but it's something that you set up. You create a position that creates a reaction. You don't artificially create that position, or you're losing speed and power. So don't do that in your throw. Do me a favor, tell me what other videos you'd like to see down below. If you have comments or you'd like, we got a whole bunch of stuff we're planning, but we wanna hear from you to see what kind of questions you have and what we can answer for you, because we're gonna have a whole bunch of cool new stuff coming. Lots of good stuff. Check out our website for free new videos. We got something new coming for there too. We had something old up for a while, but that's going away. So again, if you enjoyed this video, like, comment, subscribe, hit that subscribe button, and thanks so much, and we'll see you on the next video.